Trust me, I know what I'm doing. Never shoot that light out before it goes on. Speed, I need more speed. All right, slime bucket. You got me this time, but... Oh, no wonder my coffee's been tasting like mud lately. Where's my landlady? Probably out raising rents.
Could you help me? This door's stuck.
Bad plumbing, stuck doors. It's like living in a roach motel. That should do it. I'm Inspector Hammer. I'm a cop.
Thanks, I think.
So I guess you lost your key, right?
I don't have a key.
What, do you always break into your own apartment?
This isn't my place. Kim!
Then you're under arrest for breaking and entering.
But I didn't break in, you did.
Well, then you're under arrest for entering.
Look, my name is Sally Vincent. My cousin Kim moved in here 2 months ago, but I haven't heard from her. And I'm worried.
Yeah, she probably went out for lunch and the landlady rented her apartment.
I'm really worried about Kim. She insisted on moving in here. Wanted to see if she could make it as a model.
Well, what agency did she work for?
She was signed with the Continental Model Agency. I just came from there. They said that she did work for them 3 weeks ago, but they haven't heard from her since. This is a picture of her. I don't know what to do. If you're a policeman, I need help.
Well, you know what they say? We protect and serve and cuddle.
Looking for birthmarks, Sherlock?
No, I'm on a case here, and I thought maybe the girl's picture might be in this magazine.
Those centerfold ladies have as much on their bodies as they do on their minds.
Yes, yes.
I went through the microfilm of the newspapers for the last few months, and I found this. There is a Continental agency, and it seems to check out okay.
Hammer, a body's been found at 625 Stamford Street, apartment 15.
Why does that address sound familiar?
You live there.
I live there.
I just said that.
You just said that.
Get out of here!
This guy must have been a maniac.
Yeah.
Shot the door to pieces just to get inside.
Yeah, I always forget about that. Where is she?
Oh, she left about 20 minutes ago.
You're telling me a dead body walked out of here?
Hey, I didn't say it was a dead body. They took her to the hospital.
Oh.
Named Sally Vincent.
Yeah, I know.
Age 22. Yeah. Lives in Nebraska. Looked like a drug overdose.
Oh, drug overdose. She was squeaky clean.
What a tragedy. I do hope the poor girl will be all right. What happened to my door?
Termites, so you can forget the rent increase.
That reminds me, Mr. Hammer, your rent's past due.
Yes, so is the plumber, so when he shows, I pay.
Sure, I sit with no money while you run around chasing dead bodies.
Look, right now I'm gonna go check out a model agency, and when I get back, if that plumber has not shown up, I am personally gonna turn him into toxic waste. You got it?
What a chump.
Yes, honey. Oh, that's so good. Okay. Oh, marvelous. Yes, that's it. Okay, a little more this way. Good. Marvelous. Okay, one more there. Ah, yeah, yeah, yeah. Go, oh, I like it.
Butch, thank you. All right, Butch, you ready for the snow job? Okay, let the snow go. Okay, Cindy, let's do it. Oh, yes. More snow, Butchie. Oh, that's it, Cindy. Round this way. Good girl. Good. Loose them off. There we go. Oh, that's it. More snow, Butch. Oh, that's marvelous. They'll love this in Boston.
Oh my God. Who and what are you, you clumsy buffoon? You were disrupting a Don Merrill shoot.
I'm Inspector Sledge Hammer, and I came to ask you if you...
Bad. Can't you see we're being creative here?
Listen, Shutterbrain. I ask, you talk. You got it?
Well, you'll just have to come back later. I am on a horrible deadline. Try it again, Cindy.
Let's take this off here.
That's fine. Okay, loose the muscle. You have destroyed my entire icy white set. You are a clumsy buffoon.
Listen, Tiptoes, don't you know men don't wear earrings? Women wear earrings. Men wear tattoos.
Oh, I've got one of those, too.
Oh, you need help. I'll bet you've worn out every psychiatrist couch in town.
Oh, just shut up, you.
Hey, don't call me you. You.
I'm Jessica Hayden, and I own this studio. Now, what's going on here?
I'm Inspector Sledge Hammer, and I'm looking for information about Kim Field.
I see. Why don't we talk in my office? I'm a little behind, so I'll have to check out Christy's outfits while we chat. Try it without the robe, darling. Yes.
I understand Kim Field was with your agency.
Just for a short time. Frankly, she was too inexperienced for big-time modeling. Her cousin came in here earlier looking for her, but we had no information. Let's try it with just the teddy.
Did you know Kim's cousin Sally was in the hospital right now, unconscious? Did you know that?
Oh, how dreadful. I do hope she'll be all right.
Do you remember anything at all about Kim? Did she mention anything about relatives or contacts or kneecaps or anything?
Let's try something completely different. I'm sorry, Inspector. I really am. I wish I could help you.
Oh, baloney. The only thing you wished was that you were queen of the forest.
Inspector, I have a business to run.
Yeah? And I got a case to crack.
Inspector, I'm sorry. Our girls do not accept home phone numbers.
That's not a phone number. That's a citation for indecent exposure. The only time that girl has anything on is when she's got a coat on her tongue.
You bungling idiot! The girl's still alive now. You were supposed to stop her from going to the authorities.
I told you I am a photographer, not a killer. Besides, she never saw me. I forced some pills down her throat and ran.
Believe me, we're safe.
Maybe.
Who are you calling?
The police. If I complain to the cops about that clown Hammer ruining our shoot, then maybe it'll just get him off of our backs.
All right, Hammer, as far as you're concerned, you're off the Kim Field case. It's closed.
Oh, come on, Captain. Let me go back to that model agency. I'm telling you, something is fishy.
Go back? Why? Is there something you forgot to destroy? Jessica Hayden called me. She's mad as hell.
Captain, trust him. He knows what he's doing. Ooh, did I say that?
It's a gut instinct.
Hammer, your gut instincts almost get me fired once a week.
It's instincts that make good cops, not those silly rules against chokeholds. Hey, sometimes criminals ask me for chokeholds.
Captain, someone has to go down to that agency. It's our only link to the Fields girl.
All right, good idea. Hammer, you go back down there and you apologize, or you'll be pounding a beat on Skid Row, picking up wine bottles.
Well, this is great. Sally Vincent's in the hospital, her cousin is still missing, and we're standing around here like Mario Cuomo. Right. Poor kids don't even have next of kin to take care of them. You're a fellow woman, Duro. Think of something. Thank you.
that's your full name, Michelle Bouget.
Right.
Huh? And you have no close relatives?
No. Unfortunately, Papa died water skiing and Mama died scuba diving.
You don't mind traveling overseas on photo assignments?
Oh, no, I love ocean travel.
Good. I think you're going to make an excellent model, Michelle. Now, if you'll just sign our standard agency contract.
Okay.
And don't forget your telephone number. Welcome to Continental Models and a bright new future.
Thank you very much, Miss Hayden.
Good. Well, bye. What do you think?
She's perfect. She'll make our clients very happy.
Major, have you seen Duro?
Not yet.
Ah, that's the trouble with girls. They're always primping.
Hammer! Over here. You apologize to that modeling agency woman yet?
Sir, real men don't apologize. Frankly, I'd rather be shot.
Hammer, don't give me those kind of options. Apologize. That's an order.
Oh, come.
Apologize.
All right, girls, let's try from the top. Heads up. Chests out. Swing those... Darling, don't look down at your feet. Look, just watch me, okay? Smooth. Provocative. Alluring. Got it? Okay, quick. Let's see Brandy do that. Go ahead.
Oh. I am just not used to these shoes, Miss Hayden. They feel like cowboy boots with 9-inch heels on them.
High heels make your legs look very sexy. Now, let's just see you walk again, Brandy, okay? No, no, Brandy, you've got to try a little harder. Now, project your sensuality.
Are we doing a fashion show or a beauty contest?
Are you questioning my methods?
No. I was just wondering if we're selling the clothes, or us.
Well, why don't you let me worry about that?
Okay.
Let's just take a break, okay? Take a break now. Go on. So.
Thank you for helping me out back there. I need this job real bad. I guess I'm just trying too hard.
Oh, that's okay. What part of Texas are you from?
Oh, I'm from this little bitty town about 50 miles outside of Dallas.
Oh, yeah? You got family there?
No, afraid not. I'm the end of the line.
Yeah, me too.
You know, all the girls around here are from out of town.
Yeah. You know, it seems like none of these girls have any family.
Michelle, you were very disruptive during class. Now, I'm warning you, toe the mark or else.
I thought men weren't allowed in here.
There are no men in here.
Jessica, that crazy policeman's in your office. You know, the big one with that horrible tie that clashes with everything?
I'm going to deal with you later.
Oh, honey, let me help you with that.
So Fawn Hall turned you down, right?
What is it, Inspector? I'm very busy.
All right, look, I got something I got to say to you. Okay, didn't mean to disrupt your studio yesterday. There, I said it.
That's an apology?
It's as close as I get. I'm a cop.
Yes.
Hey, what's this doing here? That's my partner, Duro.
Partner? No, I don't think so. That's Michelle.
Michelle?
Meryl, would you bring in Michelle, please? Yeah, she's new. She said she just got in town from Canada.
This is my partner, Dory Duro. See that birthmark on her thigh right there? I remember that from a stakeout that we were on in a massage parlor. That was a crazy dude.
You wanted to see Michelle?
Oh.
Well, there she is right now. Hey, Dory, what are you doing here? You're out of uniform.
Honey, you must have me mixed up with somebody else.
Come on, Duro, what? You... didn't. Oh boy. I don't know where my head is at. I guess my eyes are just not seeing what they think they're seeing.
Probably
they think...
from mixing up too many different colors.
Yes, that's probably it. No, she doesn't look anything like my partner. No, my partner is uglier and much thicker of limb, fatter of the... And she has a big... With no, it's off. No, but I'm saying, no, you're much prettier than my partner. Listen, I really do have to go. You know how the streets are with the crime. Every kid, I'm going to try and get them.
They must be using cops for brain transplants.
Yeah.
Michelle, do you have any idea of why he called you Duro?
No. Guy's cracked. I've never seen him before in my life.
Well, I hope we understand each other. You're here to model, and that's it, right?
Right.
Good. Okay, well, you just run back to the show because we don't have a lot of time.
Okay, bye.
I don't think she's kosher.
What difference does it make? She's going to be 1,000 miles away from here after the show, and it's all legal. We've got her name on the contract.
Well, you may think it's that easy, but I'm not so sure.
Oh, mellow out, Meryl. This is our last show in this town, and then I'm going to move the whole operation to New York. Now, why don't you just go powder your nose and get ready for the show, okay? Go on.
Miss Davis, are you in there? Hey, what happened to the plumber?
What is it?
Did the plumber show up? I gotta have a gondola to walk to the bathroom.
I don't understand. I thought I saw a plumber here the other day. He left right before I found that poor girl's body.
Yeah, well, let me tell you something, Miss Davis. He didn't do a very good job, okay?
I knew he was a lousy plumber when I saw his lily white hands and his earring.
Plumbers and earrings? What's next, Teamsters and pantyhose?
You'd think on his earring it would be a little pipe or a wrench, but it was a tiny camera.
A camera?
This is our beautiful Christie, modeling an exquisite ensemble by Lupe of Paris. Notice how her gorgeous blonde hair falls on her white shoulder pads and highlights her pure silk body.
Perfect. 10,000.
I'm sure your highness meant 10,000 to start, correct?
Oh, Jessica, you always were a hard bargainer. 20,000.
Remember, you do pay for what you get.
She will be a wife.
And now, presenting Brandy, all naughty and dressed in pink.
25,000. She will be a mistress.
And now, last but not least, Michelle, feisty and full of fire.
50,000. She will be a wife and mistress.
That's it, girls. That's it. Thank you. Thank you very much. And thank you, Your Highness. I'm glad you're pleased.
Jessica, you have outdone yourself. Well, my private jet is waiting. We leave within the hour.
The girls will be ready.
Did we get the job, Miss Hayden?
I should say so. He's hiring all of you.
What agency did you say we were going to be working for?
I didn't. But believe me, it's one of the biggest in the world.
Oh, isn't that exciting? Our first big modeling job.
Okay, girls. Time to celebrate. Meryl, the champagne.
Tastes funny, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. It tastes really funny.
Well, sure. Don't worry, Abby. Come on.
Oh, yeah, that's
Model agency. It's a white slaver ring. I need help right away.
Shame on you. You're missing the party, Michelle. You forgot your drink. Drink! Oh!
Your little white slavery ring is over, Merrill.
No.
Yes. Detective Durow, police.
So, Merrill was right. You are a police officer.
That's right. And you're under arrest.
Oh, really?
She's a cop. Sledge!
Just like in the movies. Handsome leading man saves frail, helpless girl. Hey, I wore that tie to the prom, mammal face.
Took an awful chance, Doro. But good job.
Thank you.
Yeah, but what I want to know is, where do you wear a gun with an outfit like that?
Good. Thank you. Good news. Sally's gonna make a full recovery. What about our cousin?
Kim's being flown back from the Far East tomorrow.
We have the names and places of all the girls who were sold into white slavery.
Has everyone involved promised their cooperation?
Yeah, all except one group.
Who's that?
The girls in Vegas. They're having so much fun, they don't want to come back. See, you don't have to wear clothes in Vegas, and they take your they don't take it, but they say, put your money into this box, and you put it in, and you don't get it back, and they love it.
Agency. It's a white slavery ring. I need help right away.
Shame on you. You're missing the party, Michelle. You forgot your drink. Drink! Oh!
Your little white slavery ring is over, Merrill.
No.
Yes. Detective Durow, police.
So, Merrill was right. You are a police officer.
That's right. And you're under arrest.
Oh, really?
She's a cop. Sledge!
Just like in the movies. Handsome leading man saves frail, helpless girl. Hey, I wore that tie to the prom, mammal face.
Oh!
Well, this is great. Sally Vincent's in the hospital. Her cousin is still missing, and we're standing around here like Mario Cuomo. Right. Poor kids don't even have next of kin to take care of him. You're a fellow woman, Duro. Think of something.
That's your full name, Michelle Bouget.
Right.
Huh? And you have no close relatives?
No. Unfortunately, Papa died water skiing and Mama died scuba diving.
You don't mind traveling overseas on photo assignments?
Oh, no, I love ocean travel.
Good. I think you're going to make an excellent model, Michelle. Now, if you'll just sign our standard agency contract.
Okay.
And don't forget your telephone number. Welcome to Continental Models and a bright new future.
Thank you very much, Miss Hayden.
Good.
Well, bye.
What do you think?
She's perfect. She'll make our clients very happy.
Major, have you seen Duro?
Not yet.
And you're under arrest.
Oh, really?
Get her! She's a cop! Sledge!
Just like in the movies. Handsome leading man saves frail, helpless girl. Hey, I wore that tie to the prom, mammal face. Tiptoes, don't you know men don't wear earrings? Women wear earrings. Men wear tattoos.
Oh, I've got one of those, too.
Oh, you need help. I'll bet you've worn out every psychiatrist couch in town.
Oh, just shut up, you.
Hey, don't call me you. You.
I'm Jessica Hayden, and I own this studio. Now, what's going on here?
I'm Inspector Sledge Hammer, and I'm looking for information about Kim Field.
I see. Why don't we talk in my office? I'm a little behind, so I'll have to check out Christy's outfits while we chat. Try it without the robe, darling. Yes.
I understand Kim Field was with your agency.
Just for a short time. Frankly, she was too inexperienced for big-time modeling. Her cousin came in here earlier looking for her, but we had no information. Let's try it with just the teddy.
Did you know Kim's cousin Sally was in the hospital right now, unconscious? Did you know that?
Oh, how dreadful. I do hope she'll be all right.
Do you remember anything at all about Kim? Did she mention anything about relatives?
Yeah. Shut the door to pieces just to get inside.
Yeah, I was... forget about that. Where is she?
Oh, she left about, 20 minutes ago.
You're telling me a dead body walked out of here?
Hey, I didn't say it was a dead body. They took her to the hospital.
Oh.
Named Sally Vincent.
Yeah, I know.
Age 22. Yeah. Lives in Nebraska. Looked like a drug overdose.
Oh, drug overdose. She was squeaky clean.
What a tragedy. I do hope the poor girl will be all right. What happened into my door?
Termites. So you can forget the rent increase.
That reminds me, Mr. Hammer. Your rent's past due.
Yes, so is the plumber. So when he shows, I pay.
Sure, I sit with no money while you run around chasing dead bodies.
Look, right now I'm going to go check out a model agency. And when I get back, if that plumber has not shown up, I am personally going to turn him into toxic waste. You got it?
What a chump.
Yes, honey. Oh, that's so good. Okay. Oh, marvelous. Yes, that's it. Okay, a little more this way. Good. Marvelous. Okay, one more there. Ah, yeah, yeah, yeah. Go. Oh, I like it.
Butch?
That's your full name, Michelle Bouget.
Right.
Huh? And you have no close relatives?
No. Unfortunately, Papa died water skiing and Mama died scuba diving.
You don't mind traveling overseas on photo assignments?
Oh, no, I love ocean travel.
Good. I think you're going to make an excellent model, Michelle. Now, if you'll just sign our standard agency contract.
Okay.
And don't forget your telephone number. Welcome to Continental Models and a bright new future.
Thank you very much, Miss Hayden.
Good. Well, bye. What do you think?
She's perfect. She'll make our clients very happy.
Major, have you seen Duro?
Not yet.
Ah, that's the trouble with girls. They're always primping.
Hammer! Over here. You apologize to that modeling agency woman yet?
Sir, real men don't apologize. Frankly, I'd rather be shot.
Hammer, don't give me those kind of options. Apologize.
She is right now. Hey, Dory, what are you doing here? You're out of uniform.
You must have me mixed up with somebody else.
Come on, Duro. What? You.
Oh! 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 Oh, no! Oh, boy! Oh! Oh, oh I didn't. Oh! Oh! I. Oh! Oh, boy! I don't know where my head is at. I guess my eyes are just not seeing what they think they're seeing.
Probably from mixing up too many different colors.
Yes, that's probably it. No, she doesn't look anything like my partner. No, my partner is uglier and much thicker of limb, fatter of the, and she has a big, with no, it's off. No, but I'm saying, no, you're much prettier than my partner. Listen, I really do have to go. You know how the streets are with the crime, every, I'm gonna try and get them.
They must be using cops for brain transplants.
Yeah.
Michelle, do you have any idea of why he called you Duro?
No. Guy's cracked. I've never seen him before in my life.
Well, I hope we understand each other. You're here to model, and that's it, right?
Right.
Good. Okay, well, you just run back to the show because we don't have a lot of time.